welcome, my amazing viewers. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you are connecting from. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so that you'll be notified each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Thank you so much. And remember, whenever you look my video, whenever you watch my video, share the video to all platforms. Share it to family and friends. Share it in your WhatsApp group so that people can get information on what is happening in the contraption called Nigeria, mainly against the Biafrans, against the Duduas, against the indigenous people in the contraption called Nigeria. I try as much as possible to set the record straight. I don't preach hate speech. I don't speak against people. I set the record straight. The only important thing I do here is to make sure that the plight of the people remains on the front burner and the world will know the true story of what is going on in the contraption called Nigeria. Remember, they will always change the narrative. The government will always try as much as possible to use the conventional media to change the narrative, but that I will not allow. In this platform, we set the record straight and we say it the way it is. Not preaching hate speech, not by talking down to anybody, but setting the record straight and bringing the information to the front burner and letting the world know the exact situation of things. Each time you watch my video, you can equally go to the comment section. Put down your comment. Say it the way you feel it. It's so welcome. You can criticize if you so desire, but do it constructively so that we can be able to learn from one another. That is why I'm here. And now, I'm going to share with you a very important video. I hope after watching the video from the beginning to the end, you're going to enjoy the video and you continue to stick around and be able to enjoy the rest videos that are going to be coming your way from time to time. Thank you so much for coming. Today, the video I'm going to share with you is a very important video.
So, our suspicion was confirmed that the Imo State governor has embarked on such an act of hate and misrepresentation and misinformation concerning members of my family. But shockingly enough, I also had to call the police commissioner of police, who has just recently confirmed to me a few hours ago that the order came from Abuja. So I wondered if this order actually came from the Inspector General of Police. And if it is, I'm sure the Inspector General of Police must have been misinformed. But I'm yet to see what kind of offense Oluchenwosu have committed to warrant this discretion of the church and sporadic shootings that has left a lot of people injured. I want to request for the first and last time that security agencies, presidency must look into what is happening in Imo State. This affair has released the government of Imo State and members of my family. This family has gone through a lot, insult and humiliations and threat to life from the government of Imo State. But I'm yet to understand what must have informed the kind of level of misinformation that must have led the IG to give such directives. Because the IG I know wouldn't direct any policeman to go to church and shoot and arrest innocent citizens. I feel that enough of this is enough. And and Hope Uzodinma has been in the business of trying to get any member of my family or myself involved in this kind of his wicked acts of hatred. I think enough of this is enough. And I've called all people's concerned on this matter. And I hate to make this very public, but I'm being tempted to say the facts as they are. I don't want the police to get involved. I don't want the APC government led by Buhari to get involved in a matter like this that will tarnish the image of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Why should police go to the church to arrest people and arrest individual innocent person? What is the story they have written about him? I'm waiting to hear the story. I can assure you this will be a political, motivated and cooked up story now. they're going to come up with. This is one arrest too many has led to me and members of my family. There was just no justifiable reason for the police to have gone into the church to carry on such shooting exercise. Even the security attached to my family could not, because they identified the policeman. Why go to the church? Why is the shooting? Why do you have to drag the innocent boy on the floor? Why do you have to beat him up? Why do you have to push my wife? Why do you have to push my daughter? Why have to tear their clothes? There was no single arrest warrant on Uche Nwosu. Nothing at all. It was like a kidnap. If not for the fact that we have confirmed that it is police, the initial fear that this was unknown gunmen that has come to kill Uche Nwosu. But I don't know, the Uche Nwosu I know, I don't know what story will be fabricated against this young man.
Most state government is aware of the disgusting, very disgusting utterances that were met today by a former governor of the state, Rochas Okorocha. And it marks of clear panic. It looks clearly to us that he's in a panic, in a frenzy. He's in a panic because it looks like the law is gradually closing in on him. And it's expected that he will panic because the guilty is always afraid. So one is not surprised the way he's talking incoherently. If you listen to him, you find a man who is panicking, talking very incoherently. First he says that police came into the church shooting, and then the wife approached police shooting, and she was not hurt. It doesn't make sense to anybody. And then he says that they saw government house vehicles, which confirmed that His Excellency Governor Obuzo Odumasan was in the arrest. You know, but he didn't tell us which number. If he was sane enough and in a good state of mind, with all the sporadic shooting in Clem, to see government house number, he should have quoted at least one government house number, so that people can verify. In the same breath, he also says that he called the commissioner who said the order came from Abuja. Yet he's still accusing the state government. And then he's saying that the Inspector General of Police must have been misinformed. What is surprising is that if a man is innocent or feels no guilt, and the police has said that we are in custody of this man, the next thing is to allow the due process to follow. What is the haste in this press conference, trying to politicize an ordinary thing, which was is just an indigenous of Imo State and the citizen of Nigeria? And if he has run foul of the law, the police has every right to arrest him. And how they do it should not be, nobody should dictate to them how they do it. It depends on the gravity of the offense, and it depends on the information at their disposal. You know, you never can tell. Maybe they heard that maybe from there he's leaving for the airport going up. So they might decide to take necessary steps to make sure that they get him in their custody. But what is painful is that a former governor of this state, Rochas Okorocha, is busy raining abuses on His Excellency, the governor of Imo State, and saying all manner of things about him. I don't want to join issues with him. And he's claiming that he doesn't know what he has done. He has not done anything except that he raped Imo State treasury. He raped Imo State resources. He raped Imo State people and looted their common patrimony. If he's still lacking any evidence to that effect, they recently recovered the K.O. Mbadiwe University, viewed with over 40 billion of Imo State resources. Should be enough evidence. He should actually bury himself and his face in shame. And if he brings his family to you, then I say both himself and his family, they should bury their faces in shame. Because what they came to do in Imo State was to loot and steal the people's common patrimony. And because this government, ably headed by distinguished Senator Obuzo Odumma, is a government that believes in due process, that is why he has been taking his time to be able to recover these things. Roche has never believed in due process. He never respected the rule of law. However, I believe that no matter how slow the wheel of justice grinds, it will eventually and ultimately catch up with the guilty. And what former Governor Korocha has done today is only to confirm once again that he is guilty. Otherwise, why the panic? First of all, there were the people who started spreading the news, the rumor that it was an abduction gunman. And then later on, shortly after that, you are now accusing the Imo State government. Even when you have confirmed in your own words that the Commissioner of Police confirmed to you that it was order from Abuja, from Inspector General of Police. What anybody who is not guilty and who is not in panic, all he's trying to do is to whip up unnecessary sentiment. But unfortunately for him, those days when he could take Imo people for a ride are gone. Because Imo people now know him as a man who came here and looted them dry. And honestly, in a civilized society, this man should not be walking about the streets free. He should not be talking the way he's talking. He should bury his face in shame because it was a total disaster to Imo State. And that is why he's in a panic, because he doesn't know what next. If I were him, and if he's somebody who is sure of himself, what he should do is to wait for the due process of law to take his place. Thank God, nobody is taking the laws into his hands. If Uchimosi is guilty of anything, the police has arrested him. The next thing is the next step, and they find out why has he been arrested. And if he committed a crime, of course he should face the wrath of the law, because he's not above the law. So what is the point of trying to whip up sentiment that he's sure that this is part of his plan to name him and his family as those behind the banditry in Imo State? He's already indicting himself. So that is why I say he is guilty. And he's in a panic. He's in a frenzy. He's in a panic because he is guilty. And anybody who is guilty, that's the first thing, it's the first reaction is to panic and begin to talk incoherently as he's talking. As far as I'm concerned, if you listen to him as I have done, you will find that this man is in a panic and is talking incoherently. And that is not going to save to stop the course of law to take his place. If Uchimosi is guilty of anything, the law will take its course. And if Okorocha is guilty of anything, the law will take its course. So all these ones is shouting, talking about this, it's not going to serve him. What he should do, and what anybody who loves him should do, is to say, let the rule of law take its course. Not to whip up sentiments, talking about a political this and that and all this. If you politicize such a weighty thing, and mind you, for God's sake, we are facing a serious situation. Government has repeatedly said that the security in the state is politically contrived. Assuming this is why Uchimosi is arrested, I don't know, because the police will tell us eventually. So is that what we should do politics with?
Thank you so much for your patience to watch from the beginning to the end. I hope you have learned something from the video you have just watched. The video you have just watched is to bring information to your doorstep and for educational purpose. It is not to demonize anybody. Let us watch continuously and see who can be able to make a sense out of every nonsense we are seeing. We must continue. We move. It doesn't matter what they do. It doesn't matter what they say. They will kill us. Kill them. At the end of the day, Biafra is here. Thank you for watching. If you have not subscribed to the channel, please kindly subscribe to the channel. Click the notification bell so that you're notified each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Thank you and remain blessed. Bye bye. See you again. ¶¶